here. It's finally here. We've seen the label. We got to see the process. We got to go to the lines. We got to help put some stuff on pallets, wrap it up, ship it, get it the hell out of there. It's our friends from Union Craft. Good morning.
Good morning, everybody.
Oh, my goodness. Scott, who do we have with us this morning?
Adam and Jen are here. And, yes, Thirst Down, which is our hoppy fall presentation. It's a hoppy lager.
Yes.
Our fall presentation. Ravens home opener this weekend. Josh Spiegel will be at Gameday Firehouse. The first time the public will be able to get their hands on a Thirst Down will be at Gameday Firehouse. Will it be on tap? Will it be in cans? Do we know?
We've got cans heading down there tomorrow.
Hell yeah!
So we'll be enjoying these in our hand as we get excited for the first game of the season.
Thank you, pal.
Home game.
I was thinking about you guys the other day because I saw Luke Martin hanging a banner off the side of your building, who is an incredible local artist. If you don't know Luke, I've got a bunch of his stuff hanging in my house. He got in with bands. He does a lot of band posters, and he's coming out with a book, right, of all of his artwork. And I saw the building, and I'm like, God, is that the Union building? And it's so big. And what else is in that building that you guys are in?
We've got the Wine Collective, Baltimore Spirits Company, Movement Gym, where people go bouldering, Bent Coffee Roasters.
Is the ice cream shop still down
the
there?
Charmery.
Charmery.
And you know what it made me think of? It made me think of your first location, because I used to go to the first location. I used to get stuck on the street while you were unloading the cans out of the back of the truck with the forklift.
We've upgraded a little bit since then.
Yeah, and I thought, like, how far you've come. And then now we're going down there today to film a commercial, and then we were there messing around with the canning line the other day, and you were telling me how it's the biggest canning line in Maryland. I was like, I'm very proud of you guys. Like, it's very impressive what you did, and I know how much hard work goes into it, and I could never even, I can barely do this every day. I don't know how you get a brewery off the ground, make it successful, run it, grow it. Growing it's a huge thing, so bravo.
Well,
and we're just
you.
Happy to be a part of anything you guys are doing.
We don't really know how we did it either, but we're happy to be here.
But you did it. And Jen, last year we had the JSS, basically 10th anniversary Well Hello beer. And we wanted to do a small batch, and we knew it would be good. And we put it out around the summer. It was a perfect drinkable, sippable, some people cooked with it, summertime ale. That thing flew off the shelf very quickly. Actually, we kind of underestimated its popularity. And then you guys are nice enough to do a second run, and I mean, off the shelf pretty quickly. So instead of just going back to that well, which a lot of people can do, let's just punt each year and do the same Oktoberfest this, Hefeweizen and that, we have a new recipe now. So tell us specifically about the notes, the ingredients of Well Hello Beer's successor, Thirst Down, which is now a full 98 rock beer, by the way. It's not just JSS. It's JSS. It's Amelia. It's Kirk and Marianne. We've all got cans. It's a full station beer.
We all got cans.
We all got cans.
Yeah, we're excited about the six packs. We're going to have three different labels in them, so you can collect them all, find your favorite 98 Rock team members, and have fun with the labels.
Yeah, and if you actually take the labels off, cut the government warning off, you can piece them all together and make it one big piece.
That's awesome. I've seen people in the garages. You've seen people in their bars. They love to peel those things off, almost tile them. So what's different about the flavor last year to the flavor this year?
Yeah, we went from summer lager to hoppy lager.
Yeah, and this is a style of beer, hoppy lager, that we love playing around with. We've done a few different iterations of this over the years, and we keep coming back to it as like a style we want to perfect. And so this is the next iteration of it. This one's a couple tenths of a percentage lower in ABV, a little bit easier drinker, still 6.1%. It's got a little bit of punch to it, but not too much. And it's got that great kind of lighter body that you'd expect from a lager. And we paired it with some exciting new hops to create a floral, tropical fruit hop aroma and flavor to it.
I'm loving everything I'm hearing. I heard tropical fruit.
Can I, like, when it comes to the hop world and all that, hops are, they grow up on the, like, those big vine things, and they look like a beautiful little, what is it, a flower?
It's a bud.
It's a bud?
Yeah.
Like, is there new stuff?
Yeah,
or
yes. Are
there people out there like creating new hops and flavor profiles, or is it you
absolutely
just,
yeah, you know? There are hop farms that are creating new hop varieties. It takes a couple years for a hop variety to really become something that can be used in beer in a real way, And that's what we're continuing to play around with. There's one hop in here, Strata, that's relatively new that we love playing around with.
So we got that new
in here.
Yeah.
We've only used that a couple times, and we love it. And I was excited to kind of use that in this beer.
Nice.
I like that it still got a little punch to it, too, because one of the things that people liked last year is they said, if you had two Well Hello beers, you knew you had two Well Hello beers.
I love the smell, by the way.
Had some meat to it.
God, the smell. Speaks. Have you smelled it?
Yeah.
Joe, you got one over there, pal?
Yep.
Hey, cheers. It's floral. It's hoppy.
Yeah, it smells delicious.
Right.
It smells like beer. Mm. Hell yeah. Here we go.
That rolls, man.
Mm. Oh, yeah. That's good.
Oh, yeah. Pour yours into mine. I want it.
I need more. I need more already.
It's very good.
It's tasty, right?
It's got the, like, remember we talked about, like, the malty, kind of bready, toasty finish, which goes nice, cold, like, once the weather starts to dip a little bit, October, fire pit, oh, yeah.
This is bursting with fresh country flavor.
I can see, this is exactly what I wanted it to be. This is a beer I could see drinking in Lot B. Behind the Ravens broadcast area, you got somebody with a mobile propane grill. They're doing dogs. They got wings out there. Big bowl of stinky potato salad. And you got one of these things. I want people to tailgate the hell out of a Ravens game.
And in the winter, too. You could feel it in the winter.
If you like it cold, Josh, you should try it piping hot. Don't drink it like that. One of those suckers tried to trick me into doing that with Dr. Pepper. It sucked. Right, here we go.
I love it.
Yeah, it's really
good. That's kind of what I was, as the beer guy in the room, I mean, I've slowed down a lot just because of my waistline and life and everything. But
I've become a Molly guy.
I had a few, like, there's a few standout beers that you drink throughout your life that you're like, all right, I really like that. I really like that. I really like that. And I gave you a few that I really liked. And I was like, hey, maybe we can, like, lean towards that. And this is bringing all those beers that I liked. This is it, man.
That's awesome. That's what's fun when we get to collaborate with some fun partners like you all and get feelings
out
from you how we can translate it into the beer that we make. And that's when the fun stuff happens.
Now, as I sit here, Adam, owner, proprietor of Union Craft Brewing, I'm looking down at a can here
Can we talk about this?
Sure. This is another collaboration we did with another neighbor here to the station, Evermore Cannabis Company. We work with them to help them develop a THC-infused seltzer. This is uninfused I'm drinking right now, just for hydration.
But that's the can. I've had one, I'll be honest. Okay, hey, listen, come arrest me, management. I've had a cannabis-infused THC seltzer.
Legal. I had one of those about a month back, and they hit the spot.
I can't remember where I got it. It was one over by me on York Road, I think.
Yeah, they're in most of the dispensaries around the state, and pretty exciting to see that type of product out. It's one of the first THC beverages in the state. And it was a great project to figure out with them. And
so you teamed up with Evermore, and you came out with Tall, T-A-L-L. It is a Union Evermore product. It is a THC-infused seltzer. Now, there are other ones out on the market, like a Cycling Frog. There's Delta. This is different, though, right? And I've done research, and I've tried to, like, figure out what the difference is. There's a Delta 9.
There is.
And then there's how's it different? Delta 9, like, takes the whole – Delta 9, correct me if I'm wrong, uses hemp and, like, takes the whole plant and then kind of derives some THC from that. But this is actually a cannabis product.
This is cannabis, right. So the things you can buy online or at a convenience store are hemp-derived THC, which is a little different. It'll get you there, but it's a little different. Whereas these are the
it's not as full spectrum.
Yeah. Whereas the cannabis derived THC kind of does what you would expect it to.
How's it selling? What is the response?
People are loving it.
Is this the new big market that people are starting to get into? Like, you're getting into the THC seltzer space. Is this space about to explode?
Maybe. Beer. We love beer first and foremost.
You know what else you love there? Because you gave me a sip of it. Your coffee.
Yeah, that vent.
That vent coffee was fantastic.
Awesome. I almost ran back to Annapolis.
It's dangerous working where we work because there's ice cream, there's coffee, there's whiskey, there's wine.
There's ping pong tables. There's, like, little arcadey looking areas. Honestly, we're in here with Jen and Adam, Union Craft Brewing. The new beer is out this Sunday for you to try in Union Craft, and it's going to start appearing in stores next week. And it's so incredibly drinkable. And getting back to what Scott said about your space. The space is awesome. The first thing that I remember us doing there was we had a guy named Aaron Jones. And he was at Spring Thing. He was incredible. He helped kick off the evening. We did a little concert there. And if you enjoy the 98 Rock Games of Summer, you guys were nice enough to open up your house, your home there for us to compete in a bunch of that stuff. So to piggyback what Scott said about you guys keeping all these different balls in the air, you could just brew, sell, ship beer, and have a small little brewing tasting room. But you have these amazing events also. You got killer food inside. All right, you got a man back there who has glasses so thick he can see the future. And then you got these space. He knows I love him. And you've got these awesome events. Like, what's coming up this fall into the winter? Because you've always got something planned there.
Yeah, I mean, this weekend we have our Oktoberfest event that we're actually kicking off with the Hamden Toilet Bowl races.
Oh, hell yeah.
So those will start at 11. Yeah, those will start at 11. And then got the Bratwurst Boys playing live.
The Bratwurst Boys.
And we're going
to very fun.
Be doing a German spelling bee, musical chairs.
Are you spelling German words?
Yes. We have two people who are fluent in German on our staff who are going to lead the German spelling bee. And then getting later into the fall, one of our favorite events is Oyfest, another local neighbor, the local Oyster Nick.
Is that punk or Jewish? I hear Oy.
Both.
It could be one of the two. A little Rancid, a little Goldberg. Hey, Joe.
Yeah.
Schnitzel. And oh, yeah. Okay, spell okay. It.
S-C-H-N-I-T-Z-E-L.
Schnitzel. Oh, wow. Congratulations, yeah. Nico. Wow. You got to enter the German spelling
bee. Yeah, what are you doing on Saturday?
What are you doing, brother?
I like food.
Hell yeah. That's awesome, man. I love the events. I know Scott comes to them all the time. He's always coming back, singing the praises.
I missed the one anniversary party that I'm pissed about with the new master sounds, and I'm still upset. I was just listening to him the other day, and I'm like, God damn it. I'm so upset I missed that one. But I was there for Carl Dentz, and I've seen Billy Strings there. Who else have I seen there? God, I've been to a bunch. Yeah, it's great to have you guys in Baltimore.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
And thank you for the label. You have a great artist who, their name?
Alex Fine illustrated this label as well as the last one, and he is just
the same guy that did the
does.
Well Hello Beer did this as well.
Yeah. Made us all look real nice. Thank
especially
you for that,
Spiegel.
By the way.
I mean, you look like a legit football player on the label.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah, I like that.
You do look like an absolute badass.
Oh, Amelia, I'm a football player.
Looks awesome. Kirk and Marianne. Everything just, it lined up perfectly, but the most important thing, the beer in the can.
Yeah.
Is a 10 out of 10 again. So this Sunday, Gameday Firehouse, go see Spiegs, go have one of those new Thirst Downs, and then it's going to be in stores next week, Scott.
Yeah, I was going to say, so after Sunday next week, if we're talking to our listeners, just start looking around for Thirst Down popping up.
Yeah, it'll start popping up probably towards the end of next week. It takes about a week to get it to the distributor on the shelves, so by the end of next week, you certainly should see it on the shelves for next weekend and beyond, and we're made a lot more of this and plan to keep it on shelves, you know, for the next 2 or 3 months so that people can get their share and fill and get a six pack and get another six pack. Please. And get another six pack.
I'm begging you. Bella's Liquors in Annapolis, Maryland. The Sullivan sisters, I love them to death. They got a pool they call Thunderdome. They had a ton of Well Hello beer and they moved it the minute they got it. So if anybody can see to it, then my friends at Bella's get some. Jen, Adam, please extend our thanks to everybody down there for another big batch of hard work making this happen. I had a quarter of one and I feel it. I'm going to say something.
Yeah, I feel great.
Meeting. I'm going to be real honest. I'm going into the meeting without my shirt on. He's going to see my chest, my entire chest.
He needs to.
Oh, Christ, they're still here. Adam, Jen, thank you guys so much.
Thank you guys.
We appreciate it.